Good evening, welcome.
I'm Brett Beeson, Director of Music Therapy, and on behalf of the faculty, I'd like to welcome you all. Glad to see a great crowd out supporting the students and the faculty right now, especially. We'd like to thank First Congregational Church for allowing us the beautiful space. Might remind you to silence cell phones, make sure that you don't have any interruptions that you don't intend happening. And want to encourage you to take in the music tonight, right? We've been focused on a lot of things in the last month, but it's time to just be in the music. Okay? And the students, I think, appreciate that as well, being able to be in the music and not thinking about some other things right now. So, welcome you all, and I'd love to introduce the Marietta College Choirs under the direction of Dr. Jay Dougherty.
Thank you. Next on our program is I Believe, a song that beautifully encapsulates the enduring power of faith and hope in times of darkness and uncertainty. With its repeated refrain of belief, even when the sun isn't shining, when love is not felt, and when God is silent, this song serves as a poignant reminder of the unwavering human spirit. It underscores our theme of peace and unity by highlighting the universal capacity to maintain faith, love, and a sense of connection even in the face of adversity, ultimately reinforcing our shared belief in a better, more harmonious world.
Even when
the enduring human spirit's commitment to pursue peace and unity.
Thank you. Tulsa Treble Choir's portion of the concert, they will now sing Sisi Ni Moya, a celebration of the unity of humanity. This captivating composition reminds us that regardless of our differences, we all share common emotions, dreams, and aspirations. The lyrics beautifully emphasize the idea that we are one world, one people, breathing the same air and striving for the same goals. Through harmonious melodies and uplifting rhythms, Sisi Ni Moya exemplifies the universal desire for peace and unity, uniting us all in celebration of our shared humanity. This song serves a powerful testament to the idea that despite the diversity of languages, cultures, and experiences, we are bound by our common hopes and dreams for a better world.
Thank you.
lyrics and evocative melody serves as a reminder of the complexities and challenges that may arise in human relationships. Through its narrative, it highlights the importance of communication and understanding in fostering peace and unity, showcasing the longing for harmonious connection. Despite the struggles depicted in this song, its presence in our program underscores the universal desire for reconciliation and the hope that by addressing our differences and misunderstandings, we can build bridges to lasting peace and unity. This song was arranged by Dr. Jay Doherty by request of soloist and music education and vocal performance senior Victoria Humphrey. This song will also be featured in Flood Stage's newest music video, which will be released in a few weeks. We invite you to subscribe to the Marietta College YouTube page to be notified of its release. Until then, please enjoy Linger.
Childhood dreams to adulthood challenges, emphasizing the unyielding spirit within each of us.
As the chorus proclaims, "We are the warriors that built this town," it serves as a reminder of the strength and collective effort required to overcome adversity and construct a harmonious community. This anthem of unwavering resolve and the pursuit of a better world will unite us all in our shared commitment to peace and unity. Maurice Riley, the featured soloist, brings this song to life with passion that we all share through the message we sing. We invite you to join Flood Stage at their combined performance with the Marietta College Jazz Ensemble on November 15th. The details are in your program. Now please enjoy Warriors.
Thank you. Marietta College Concert Choir now continues our exposition of piece by singing The Shower, a delicate and introspective choral piece that offers a contemplative exploration, renewal, and awakening. The text, which metaphorically likens a cloud's gentle rain to the potential softening of the human heart, carries a profound message of transformation. Elgar's composition, with its gentle harmonies, the lyrical melodies, beautifully captures the essence of a hopeful and unified human spirit. The Shower invites us to reflect on the cyclical nature of life's challenges and the promise of rejuvenation, connecting us through our shared experiences and aspirations for a brighter, more harmonious future.
The solemnity and ethereal beauty of the music combined with the Latin text Kyrie Eleison, translating to Lord have mercy, implores sense of humility and the universal longing for divine guidance and reconciliation. As we experience this remarkable composition, we are reminded of the transcendent nature of music and its ability to connect us all, transcending cultural and temporal boundaries in the pursuit of peace and unity. Rose Wardlow is our featured soloist.
Thank you. sentiment speaks the dedication, resilience, and unwavering passion that our singers and faculty have shown in the face of adversity. The text message of finding light even in the midst of sorrow and hardship resonates deeply with our shared experiences, reminding us that no matter the obstacles we face, we are not alone in our journey. "You Do Not Walk Alone" symbolizes the strength of our music community, offering a source of inspiration and unity as we continue to create, reform, and find solace through music, so long as we are allowed to do so.
Thank you.
evokes the spirit of unity and divine celebration. The lyrics, which extol rejoicing in the Lord and the splendid garments adorning both heaven and earth, emphasize the harmonious connection between humanity and the Creator. Hayden's skillful orchestration and joyful melodies in Awake the Harp reflect the universal themes of awe and gratitude, reminding us of the profound impact of music in uniting individuals in praise and adoration of the divine. This composition exemplifies the power of music to unite us, transcending time and place in a shared expression of awe, reverence, and unity.
Thank you.
Love Cast Off Fear, arranged by our director, Dr. J. Doherty, was recently published by Mount County Music Publishers. And tonight's performance will be the world premiere. The song delivers a poignant message of unwavering faith and transformative power of love. The lyrics convey the idea that divine love is a source of inner peace and strength capable of dispelling fear and uncertainty. In the context of our theme centered on peace and unity, the song serves as a powerful reminder that love's profound influence can bring about a world where fear and discord are cast aside, and true harmony and unity can flourish.
The song we're about to sing tells the following story. Sadako Sasaki was born on January 7, 1943. She was a 2-year-old living with her family in Hiroshima when the bomb was dropped on the city.
Their house was about a mile from the center of the blast. She was not hurt at the time, even though the house was destroyed. Over time, their lives returned to normal, and Sadako experienced no effects from the exposure to radiation from the bomb. However, in 1954, when she was 11 years old, tragedy struck. Sadako was diagnosed with leukemia, and the doctors gave her a year to live. In the hospital, Sadako was told of a legend that if a person were to fold 1,000 paper cranes, their wish would come true. For months, using whatever paper she could find, including medicine labels and paper scraps from other patients' get-well presents, Sadako folded cranes. In the end, she had many more than 1,000. During her time in the hospital, her condition progressively worsened. After her family urged her to eat something, Sadako requested tea on rice and remarked, "It's tasty." Those were her last words. With her family around her, Sadako died on the morning of October 25, 1955, at the age of 12. The statue of Sadako was placed in the Hiroshima Peace Park thanks to the fundraising efforts of her former classmates. The engraving on the statue reads, "This is our cry. This is our prayer. Peace for the world." Many of the cranes were donated to museums by the Sasaki family. One of them, a tiny red crane, was donated by her brother to the memorial at the World Trade Center site in New York City. Heiwa is the Japanese word for peace. At the writing of this song, 61 years had passed since Sadako died. The message proudly embossed on her life banner was apparent. She wasn't self-absorbed. She didn't cave to self-pity. Her hope was for peace. Imagine the effect if we, 60-plus years later, picked up her banner and wore it proudly. Before you leave tonight, we invite you to take a paper crane home with you. We made these for you to remind you of tonight's performance and to serve as a future reminder to always foster peace. So please take one as a thank you from us on your way out. In addition, the back of your program shows the crease design of an unmade paper crane. How will you create paper cranes in the world? How will you foster peace?
love you all. You know.